I know I need to change something to get what an insurance company owes me because of a car accident, but it could also come somewhere else. I mean, let's say the abundance I wish for.
The thing is, it's more difficult to come from someplace else when you are feeling the injustice of it not coming from a place you believe it should come from. You have to let go of your indignation before it can come through another avenue, or even through that avenue.
So the solution is not to see insurance companies fair, it's just to believe in the abundance the universe provides for everyone.
The thing is, we played with that a little bit, as sometimes the same person was on the stage again, when there are so many of you who want to be here. And the reason that we said it's always fair, it may not be even, but it is always fair. And the meaning behind that is that we know what your vibrational intentions are, and we know what the outcome is likely to be of a conversation. We know the value of it to you, and we know where you are in proximity to what you want, and we know what the path of least resistance is. And we're speaking for the universe at large and for law of attraction as well. It always works out in perfect vibrational accordance to whatever vibration you've got going on. And so, even in the example that we've been giving about the court case, where there are two people with very different perspective of what happened, often both believing that what they are saying is absolutely true. And so there's not so much a physical way of sorting it out, but there is always a vibrational way of sorting it out. Esther said to us in the beginning, "But Abraham, it's true. This is true. So shouldn't I talk about it because it is true?" And we said, there are so many things that are unwanted that are also true. Why keep active in your vibration something that is true that you don't want to continue to replicate?